day. We're down here at the Embarcadero, and I don't really come to this location that often. Do you hang out here?
I come down here every once in a while with the family, but what's kind of cool is, like, before there wasn't all this walkability. I mean, it put in all like this really cool like walking paths and like areas for people to sit and eat.
Yeah.
And obviously the USS Midway's right over here, so we bring the family down for that.
I used to come here years ago. I went on the Star of India. Okay. You got to check out the old ship and sail, but I feel like there's so much more action down here.
Obviously, I've been selling real estate for 20 years, and like this whole downtown skyline has completely changed.
It has.
You have high rises. I mean, the cool part about it though is that the Manchester, like the Pacific Gateway, is going in like right around the corner.
That is an incredible project. I heard they're pumping in over $1 billion.
$1.5 billion.
What?
And I mean, the best part about that is like they're really incorporating like walking paths. There's lots of open space. I think it was 12 years to plan that dang thing.
Incredible.
So I mean, the really cool part about that is just, yeah, it's right there when that's done.
All right, so I know anytime I hang out with you, I'm in for some wild adventure. What do you have up your sleeve this time?
Yeah, I have a question for you. Are you feeling patriotic?
I'm always patriotic, I like to think.
All right, well, I have just the boat for you.
Uh-oh, that makes me nervous.
Let's check it out, come on.
Flagship cruises and events, because that wasn't just a cruise, that was an event. That was so much fun.
It was so awesome. My hands are sweating right now. Yeah. That was just killer.
Mark, thank you guys for coming, man. I'm glad you guys enjoyed it. And our jet boat is one of a kind here in San Diego, as you got to experience. You know, holds 129 people. You wouldn't think that you have a jet boat that can hold 129 people. And going 50 miles an hour. You got the winds blowing through your hair.
I mean, no hair.
Yeah.
Yeah, my hair was standing on end. Yeah. I'm sure when we were going this way, then we were going that way, and my hair was doing the same.
Yeah.
I mean,
yeah.
What a thrill. You don't think going into it when you sit down in the seats, that, and they hand you the poncho, and you were like, hey, maybe we should grab these ponchos.
Poncho, seatbelt. If someone raises their hand or puts their hand in their head, we might have to stop for a second. I'm like, whoa, what's going on here?
Whoa, I always know when we meet up, there's gonna be some sort of thrilling adventure, but I had no idea. That was so much fun. And the fact that that boat, that big of a boat, can turn on a dime like that, unbelievable. How can it do such a thing?
Well, so it's got two 1,400 horsepower jet-propelled engines. So, like I had said earlier, it's like one big jet ski and a roller coaster on the water. And with it having those jet-propelled engines side by side like that, it's able to spin like that. So,
when they crank up great music, little Ozzy Osbourne, some rap, it was just like awesome. We're like a concert. You're cruising. The captain was totally cool.
It's
amazing.
Like you said, roller coaster. I kept trying to sneak my hands up, and as soon as we did, it would be like, whoa, we're out of control. We're going this way again. Those poor kayakers that we passed, they got sprayed. Uh-huh. They're like trying to pedal as fast as they can to get out of the way. This thing was so much fun. Yeah, I really, really enjoyed it, but that's not all you have in store here with Flagship.
Yes.
What else do you offer?
Yeah, so Flagship Cruises, we've been around since 1915. So even before the Coronado Ferry Before the bridge was here, we had the ferry boats that went to Coronado that actually carried the cars. And, you know, we're still operating the ferries today, but just passenger vessel. Then we do nightly dinner cruises, Saturday and Sunday champagne brunch, harbor tours,
which is coming in right now.
So this is our daily harbor tours, 7 trips a day, 7 days a week. Then we do private events and charters and weddings, and then in the winter months we even do whale watching. So a little bit of everything.
So cool.
Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
So really, you have a little bit of something for everybody.
Yep.
I mean, we're kind
the
of thrill adrenaline
seeker type, and then family trips. I mean, this is just a narrated harbor tour. It's great for the family and kids just to be out on the water and learn more about San Diego. A little bit of everything on the bay.
That's awesome.
Yeah, I mean, the funny part about it is, so I actually been on the Patriot boat before with my kids. We were walking by and we were down here. Downtown's so sweet, right, in this spot in the Embarcadero. And my kids are like, we want to go on that. Yeah. I look up, I'm like, all right, let's do it. So I rolled up and, then I met Tim after that. I'm like, hey, man, we got to get this on the show. Yeah. But it's good for my son was 4 at the time, so and he loved it. So.
Yeah, I think just where we're located here, like being downtown, right next to the USS Midway, just south of Broadway Pier, right along the Embarcadero, the amount of foot traffic that we get here, even the cruise ships that come here, just a nice, convenient location. So.
And I feel like you really appeal to everybody, young and old, because there were some kids on our boat that were just completely drenched, having the time of their life, like 5 years old, and then there was some older folks on there who were equally screaming their heads,
fist pumping,
having the time of their life. Yeah. And what a fun experience. I feel like that's really what San Diego's about, right? Having fun, being on the water.
Can't beat it.
Yeah.
Especially, it's getting a little hot out here. Yeah.
I know. So what's your busiest time of year? If I want to come and bring my family or my friends, maybe what are the better days to come, or is any day a good day to come?
Well, of course I'm going to say any day. But of course, right in the middle of summer, weekends are going to be the most busiest. So if you're really wanting to get here, making sure you get a spot, come in the middle of the week. That would probably be the best way, Then you're
guaranteed
almost guaranteed to get a spot,
I mean, we had the thrill, we had the time of our lives, but what a cool job, being out on the water, just enjoying that San Diego lifestyle. So incredible. Thanks so much for showing me, Mark, the
you're
light
welcome.
Here. This was so much fun.
Yeah, I had a blast. Thanks.
I'm glad you guys were able to come down.
We really appreciate
it.
Awesome. Thanks a lot.